Want to learn Excel's index match? I'll show you how to use it with a single click, just like this. What is an index match? It is the combination of two functions that will help you find and show values in a table. It's like the Vlookup, but better. First, I'll explain index, then match, and finally, I'll show you how to use them together. Let's start with the index function. It tells you what's in a cell where a row and column meet if you tell it where to look. For example, we want to find the number of views for Stranger Things. We can see it's in the third row and second column. Type in equals index. It'll ask for three things. 1, where should it look? Pick your whole table. 2, the row number. Stranger Things is in row 3, so type 3. 3, the column number. Views are in column 2, so type 2. Close your formula and press enter. It shows there were 286 million views. Pretty easy, right? The problem with this tool is it's a bit stiff on its own. You have to type in the row and column number yourself. But by using the match function, it can automatically find the row and column numbers for us. So, to find the row number for Stranger Things, you just need to type equals match. It will ask you for three things. 1, what you are searching for. Type Stranger Things. 2, where should it look? If we want to find Stranger Things, we should look in the list with all the show names. 3, the match type. We want an exact match, so type 0. Close your formula and press enter. It says row 3. To find the views column, use match again. You want to find the views column, so type in views. You should look across all your columns, so select them. Then type in 0 for an exact match. Close your formula, press enter, and done. It shows column 2. All right, let's put everything together, and I have a cool trick to make it super easy. But before we go on, hit the subscribe button because every week, I'm gonna give away a complete Excel course worth $300 to 10 of my subscribers. Now, let's continue. Start with the index function. The area it should search is your whole table. Lock it with F4. This way, when you drag the formula down, the area stays the same. The row number is 3, and the column number is 2, right? Close your formula and you're set. For the row number, we'll use match to find Stranger Things. You want to find the show's name. Pick it from your table and lock it with F4. This way, when you drag the formula down, it keeps searching for the show. We want Excel to look in the list with all the show names, so select it and lock it with F4. Like before, for an exact match, type in 0. For the column number, start another match. You're looking for the views column, but don't lock this one. This way, when you drag the formula down, instead of looking for views, it will look for the audience rating and Rotten Tomatoes score. We want Excel to look across all your columns, so select them and lock the range with F4. For an exact match, type in 0. Now, here's the cool trick I was talking about. Writing the index match formula all at once can be confusing because it can get really long, and it's easy to make mistakes. What I do is just replace the row and column numbers with the match formulas. Type an asterisk in your index function. This turns it into text so you can change it. Then, take the match formula for the row number, copy it, and paste it into your index function. Do the same with your other match for the column number. Delete the asterisk, and there you go. We have the views for Stranger Things. Drag your formula down, and you get the other numbers. If you change it to Black Mirror, you'll see its data. So much easier, right? Want another cool trick? If you want to see what percent of the total views each show has, you can make a pie chart. But that's magic for another video, which I'll link up here. See you there.